अस्सलाम वालेकुम जी, होप यू आर डूइंग गुड। दिस इज़ उस्मान आबिद एंड यू आर वाचिंग माय यूट्यूब चैनल। द लास्ट लेक्चर वी डिड द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ स्पेसिफिक रिलीफ एक्ट 1877। फ्रॉम टुडे वी विल सी व्हाट काइंड ऑफ रिलीफ्स आर प्रोवाइडेड अंडर दिस एक्ट। सो द फर्स्ट टाइप ऑफ रिलीफ विच इज़ प्रोवाइडेड इज रिकवरी ऑफ पोजेशन ऑफ प्रॉपर्टी, दैट इज इन चैप्टर 1। It goes from section 8 to section 11. Section 8 and 9 is all about recovery of possession of immovable property, while section 10 and 11 is about recovery of possession of immovable property. So today we'll do section 8 and 9. So there is a big difference between section 8 and 9. So first see what section 8 says. It states that a person entitled to the possession of specific immovable property may recover it in the manner prescribed by the Code of Civil Procedure. It is a very short section, but trust me, it's very, very deep. See the words, a person entitled to the possession. That means only the owner, only the person who holds the title of an immovable property, he can file a suit for recovery of possession under this section. See, if any person holds a title, he is the owner of the property, he got the title through any mode of transfer of property, like through sale, through exchange, through gift, through inheritance, first thing he will have to prove his title, that how he got this title. He will have to prove that he is the owner of the property. Only that person can file a suit for recovery of possession of any immovable property under this section. This is the major requirement, that you will have to prove your title. Second thing, that person who is the owner of any property, any immovable property, he has been dispossessed from that property, or he never got the possession of that property. I'll give you an example of this one. The person who, the owner who has been dispossessed from the property, I'll give you an example that if I do have a land, an immovable property, and my co-sharer dispossesses me from the from that land, though I am the owner of the property, I would be able to file a suit under this section. I'll go to the court and I'll prove to the court that I am the owner, I had the possession, and I have been dispossessed by the co-sharer. So second thing is that I have bought a property, a land, and I paid the price, I've got the title documents, I'm the legal owner of that property, but the possession was never transferred to me. In that scenario as well, I can file a suit under section 8 for the recovery of possession of that property. So first thing first, the only owner can file a suit. He will have to prove his title. If he has been dispossessed or he never got the possession of the property, he can file a suit under this section. The next thing is written that may recover it in the manner prescribed by the Code of Civil Procedure. Specifically mentioned that the regular procedure which is provided under the CPC for the for a suit, regular proceedings through regular if we file a suit under this section, the regular proceedings shall be adopted by the court to decide the suit. That means that first you will file a plaint, then the defendant shall be summoned, he will appear, he will file his written statement, then issues shall be framed, then the evidence shall be recorded, and finally suit will be decided. So the regular procedure shall be adopted for a suit to be decided under this section. Next thing, the limitation. limitation for this section of to file a suit under this section is 12 years. Within 12 years a suit can be filed under this section. The next one is section 9. This is absolutely different from section 8. It states that if any person is dispossessed, I'll stop here, because in section 8 it was written that a person entitled to the possession, that means the only owner, while in section 9 it is written if any person is dispossessed. So that means that the person who is dispossessed, it is not compulsory for him to be the owner. Any person who is dispossessed, he can file a suit for recovery of possession under this section, under section 9. Second thing, without his consent. So doesn't matter he is owner of the property or not, but he has been dispossessed without his consent of immovable property otherwise than in due course of law. The third thing is that the person who is dispossessed by somebody, he has been dispossessed without adopting the due process of law. I'll give you an example of this one. See, if I do have a house and I rent it out, but the tenant is not paying me the rent, so what is the procedure I should adopt to dispossess him? I should file an application before the rent tribunal, and then whatever the decision is, but it is I cannot dispossess him forcefully. So this is the due process of law should be adopted. But the person, doesn't matter who is the owner of the property, he is dispossessed against his consent and without adopting the due process of law, he can file a suit under this section. Next it says, he or any person claiming through him may by suit recover possession thereof, notwithstanding any other title that may be set up in such suit. That whoever is dispossessed, he can file a suit, or any person on his behalf can file a suit. The third thing is clearly states that the title, it is immaterial, that is not that won't be considered under this section. So the next thing it says, that nothing in this section shall bar any person from suing to establish his title to such property and to recover possession thereof. In the first paragraph it was said that title is immaterial, but in the second paragraph it is said that if somebody who is filing a suit, who has been dispossessed from the property, if he wants to prove his title, so there is no bar at him. If he wants to prove his title, he can do that, but that is not compulsory. It is just up to the plaintiff or the person who is dispossessed, if that he wants to establish his title or not. The next thing is that no suit under this section shall be brought against the central government or any provincial government. Central, it is, word is central, but it should be federal, because this is an old written act, but it should be federal here. So in this paragraph it is said that against federal government or provincial government, if they dispossess somebody else, so no suit can be filed under this section, under section 9. In the last paragraph it is said that no appeal shall lie from any order or decree passed in any suit instituted under this section, nor shall any review of any such order or decree shall be allowed. So in the last paragraph it is clearly mentioned that whatever the order is passed or decree is passed, if a suit is filed under this section, that order or decree won't be appealable. No appeal is provided under for this section. Not even a review can be filed, but under CPC it is said that it is very clear that where appeal doesn't lie, a revision can be filed. So a revision can be filed, but an appeal cannot be filed against the order or decree of under this section. So one thing I said in the last section, that it is clearly mentioned that regular procedure shall be adopted. It is specifically mentioned in section 8, but nothing in this section 9 mentioned like this. The reason is that it is a summary procedure. It is a speedy remedy provided for the persons who has been dispossessed from the property. So summary proceedings for section 9 and regular proceedings for section 8, that's the difference. Lastly, the limitation to file a suit under this section is provided in Limitation Act Schedule 1 Article 3, that is 6 months from the date of dispossession. Within 6 months, a suit can be filed for recovery of possession of immovable property under section 9. So if I sum up the things here, so section 8, only owner can file. In section 9, anybody can file a suit who has been dispossessed. Title has to be proved in section 8, but in section 9 there is no requirement like this. Regular proceedings for section 8 and summary proceedings for section 9. The limitation for section 8 is 12 years to file a suit. In section 9 it is only 6 months. I hope I've cleared all the I've cleared all the ambiguities between these two sections. They are interrelated, but they are absolutely different from each other. So anyway, thank you very much. Take care, Ji. Allah Hafiz.